If your wife defends a bit fire along Sunday, then remember she got stuff scattered into the hall. If you leave by these doors, to my left, to my right, we go down to the front of the school and exit the main door and wait on the car in the hall. You'll be told when to return. Secondly, forms. If I ask you to switch them off, I know you won't, because I don't. But if you could put them on silent, we would appreciate that. And also, please, again, we usually say please no flash photography, so that's 19. So can I ask you, it's okay, we don't stop you taking pictures, as long as you don't stop me taking the video, but if you could switch the flash off, please. So it would be nice, so if you could do that, that'd be great. Interval, you don't need to unless you want to go to the restrooms, as they say in Florida. If you stay, there'll be mince pies and hot chocolate will be served to your seats at the interval. And at the end of the interval, we will signify the end of the interval by a bell. When the bell goes, you have 3 minutes to get back, if that's okay. Have I anything else to tell you? Oh yes, as I said, it's pantomime now, just a bit of a tip. If you don't want to take part, don't drop your head. Because when the Dame Dotty Dibble, little new meat comes out, she'll be looking for one or two. Now if you do this, you're a dead money to be picked on. If you look her full in the face, she'll leave you alone. But one or two would be a mark, she's running with this, don't worry. Now, the cast of last give you a few jokes to one. One year old best to get the pantomime of these go. These are hot off the email, off the internet. I wonder if this is rumour or not, the kids don't tell you this. I hope it's not rude. What does Miley Cyrus have at Christmas? Twerking! Why did no one bid for Rudolph and Blitzer on eBay? Stop! Mary and Joseph. Yeah. Now they have a stable relationship. It's nice to see tonight's one of our ex-students, that young man over there, who looks now with his beard as he looks about 65. He's only 20, how old are you now?
23.
He's about 65. Get your beard off! He used to perform on stage, that's why I'm picking at him. And basically, how did Mary and Joseph know that Jesus weighed 7 pounds 6 ounces when he was born? You haven't got that one, have you? You don't know that one? Because they are away in a manger. Oh. And the last one, which I know, this is from one of the cast. Yes, where's Nathan? Where are you? Where's Nathan? Oh, he's gone now. To ask, he's gone back. I'll have to the light. I went to the library yesterday. I went to the library, you know this one. We're in the library, and there was a chicken in the library. And the chicken was at the shelf and had a book. It was really weak. So the chicken got his book on its way. It's a chicken with a book. And we walked in and said, what's this chicken doing? The chicken went, with a book on its way. Walked down to the going, and the chicken met a frog. The chicken went, the frog went, ready.
Thank you.
Later on, that's where we're bound, but for now, we'll stay on the ground. The setting for this, our opening scene, is much muddling village green. Over there lives Widow White.
Hello, how you doing? You all right?
In her neat cottage to my right, complete with cow shed at the back, she has two sons called Billy and Jack.
Our village. So look on the bright side. Don't be silly. Billy, why have you only got one glove on?
Yeah, the weather forecast said it would be warm, but on the other hand, it could be cold.
I want to do shoelaces are untied.
That's because the label inside said Taiwan.
And you're so late. The market's over and we haven't sold anything. Well, you'll be explaining this to Mother when she gets here.
Do that for me! think you could do that for me?
Yes!
Well, let's have a wee bit of role play then, shall we? Hello, everybody!
Hello, everyone!
You can't be serious, can you? I think we should try that again, don't you? Hello, everybody!
Hello, everyone!
Oh, that was nice, wasn't it? Now though, oh, if you were a McDonald's burger, you would be the McGorgeous. Right, now, there's a real reason for me coming in this evening. I am here on official business for my launderette. Somebody has nicked my knickers and burgled one of my bras. So, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to come out with the fabric conditioner and I'm going to try and smell my knickers out. Not like that. They are clean. Right, okay. Let's have a wee little flirt. Don't worry, sweetheart. You won't burn. It's not acid. Okay, we're drunk here. You won't get red. You'll burn. It's acid. Oh, are you a wee little pink boy? Oh, yeah. Oh, you're gorgeous. You are, aren't you? You've got a perfect face. A perfect face for radio. What's that I can smell? What is this? Do you like unwrapping things, miss? Or would you mind just unwrapping that for me? Hurry up and knock it all day. Come on! Oh, for goodness sake! Hurry up! What on earth is this? I think somebody on this table likes to wear bras. Now, because there's four ladies on the table, I'm going to assume that this one is yours. So, do you like wearing bras, sir? Because what you wear on a Saturday night with your wife. And a Sunday is on fire, this one. So, why don't you try it on for a little bit? Come on. Oh, come on, sir.
Which ones do you take? The boys and the girls?
Well, personally, I have the boys. You get extra bets. Oh, yay. You know what? I also supply the whole village with a wee little bit of milk. Well, not me personally, but only I can manage the whole village. You see, I've got a cow. Her name's Buttercup. Oh, she's the love of my life. All the fun times we've had together, squirting milk in the stables. Right, no. But I say she's the love of my life, but I've got two sons as well. Have you met Jack and Billy Eggs?
Yes!
I'll ask you again. Have you met Jack and Billy Eggs?
Yes!
That's not. Then, Jack. Jack's a good lad. He helps me around the house. He does all the washing, the cooking. You know what? He even scrubs me back from time to time. But Billy. Well, let's just say Billy's not all that right. I think he was born in a power cut. But we are poor.
Aww.
I was waiting for an aww, but I didn't get one, so shall we try that again? I am poor.
Aww.
You see, I've got men after me, unpaid taxes, and I can't afford to pay them. Are we worth a penny?
I have warned your son already.
I don't have a son called already.
And now I'm warning you. If I catch that cow on my land once more, I'm going to deal with her permanently. And that's not the only matter to discuss. You're behind.
Any more than you are a take with my anatomy, and I will not be responsible for my actions.
You are behind on rent.
Oh, right.
That. I haven't seen any rent from you in the past 6 weeks.
Funny really, isn't it? Because I haven't seen any of it myself.
And I'm not having hangers-on living rent-free in one of my cottages.
Look here, Squire Grey. I'm not standing about having answered about my family. We might be hard up, run down and all in. But hangers-on, never.
I never pay us up, neither. It's like another one of my tenants. She always kept her rent in her ears.
Ooh, what a funny place to keep your ears.
She doesn't anymore.
Why's that?
I threw her out. We'll see exactly what I'll do to you if you don't pay up. 6 weeks rent for the next 7 days.
Oh, you can't be serious, can you?
Try me. And if I don't get it, then out you go. The lot of you, including that cow. If I had shot her first.
How on earth does he expect me to pay him back? I can't afford anything. I really do hope my wee lads have managed to make some money down at the market today. Oh, funny that. Here you are. How did the market go?
Well, it went like this.
Don't you see? Billy and I simply couldn't bear to sell any of your precious kitchenware for a fraction of its worth. It was just too upsetting.
How on earth do you expect me to pay Squire Grey back now? Oh, I'm just a poor, oh, lonely window. Well, young, I never needed anyone. I'm making love with just for fun.
Pull yourself together!
I'm not a pair of curtains!
Guess what? Well, what?
let me come close. Well, you see, I'm just having a wee bit of trouble with, you know, Squire Grey. No!
Don't let anyone.
He says, right, he says to throw me out of my cottage just because I owe a wee bit of rent.
As if he has more money than he knows what to do with it!
I'm gonna tell him.
The richest landowner for miles and the most miserable.
I'm just too poor. Oh, lonely. Wait, don't.
Widow! Oh, yeah, you lost your husband in yet. Well, never mind. Look, there's plenty more fish in the sea.
I know, but my bet isn't as fresh as it is to be.
You can send a phone to a lonely heart club.
No. I did, but they sent it back. They said they weren't that lonely. I've got one, two sons and then a cow to bring up. And then at the end of the week, I've only got £10 to spend on my beauty treatment.
Oh,
are you being serious?
Why, of course I am.
I've got a phone number that you might need.
Oh, thank you very much. Is it for a modeling agency?
No, it's the solicitors. He'll help you get your money back!
you're going to be spending money then?
Oh no, that plastic surgery just got my spending.
Plastic surgery?
Yes, I had my Barclay card cut off.
You know what's quite great, that cut off?
Ooh, it's going to cut off a lot. Am I getting lucky tonight? Oh, come on, tell me.
Your electricity! Might cut off your electricity!
Oh, how embarrassing! The shame of that!
You all, clear off! Get away from here! Just hanging about, gossiping, just standing around.
Standing around? Something you would never do! He never goes anywhere near the golden ball. You know, standing around to get around, you know? Okay.
I have a mind of my own.
Ew, he does!
It's a pity you didn't bring it with you then, isn't it?
It is!
What I have, I hold.
He holds it.
We hold it, let's go!
Make no secret of the fact either, do you?
Make no secret of the fact I'm a self-made man.
A self-made man!
And a good example of a skilled labour.
A skilled labour!
I want no misunderstanding. It's all mine, I won't share it with anybody else.
Except us.
Well, you know what? I would touch it with a bag pole.
Well, we need more.
Because you're desperate.
It's my private property. My estate is mine, nobody else's.
Excuse me, did you just say your private property? That's what I was on about. His estate.
What? Stop off.
It's your estate, Robert. No trespassers of any kind, two-legged or four-legged, so don't say I've been warned.
And a Merry Christmas to you too, Squire Grey.
Why, is he such a selfish soul, was he?
He's forgotten how to smile.
That's why he has no brain at all.
Yeah, that would cost me a ring, either, would it?
Even if I didn't have a single penny in my pocket, you'd always catch me with a smile.
Oh, me too, keeps my features beautiful. Are you ready?
Yes.
So where are you from first then?
And what's happened to all your teeth?
They are there.
Oh no, right, but seriously, you know what keeps me smiling?
What's that?
That's a wee little bit of exercise.
Exercise?
Yes, right. And the world record at the moment is 500 miles. Yes. And I'm planning on breaking that record and making it 500 miles.
Dora, never mind us two. What about them?
Yeah, they've just got a fitness training.
Yeah.
So why don't we all do a wee bit of exercise? So we're going to need you all on your feet, please. All on your feet, please!
All on your feet, please!
Right, okay. So the answers are pretty simple. Let's get going, shall we? Maestro, cue the song. Get your feet up, get moving.
Anyway, any best would have for me to have a determination. strike. I agree. And I suggest we call an emergency meeting of 6:45.
Yes. And tell them to consider the situation in detail. Then put forward further proposals.
We shall arrange it at once.
Go.
Now to Cloudland, where you see the giant is holding prisoners 3, the princess with attendants 2, a sister and brother, Polina and Hugh, a maid and coachman who were with her, so the giant took all 3 thither. They don't find anything to cheer in Cloudland's murky atmosphere. No sunshine, it is always dim, their future too is looking grim.
Wishing day, a day when any heartfelt wish will come true.
must make a positive impression. Brains more working, more attentive, working out increased incentive. How to guarantee success in rescuing a royal princess?
The reward shall be increased.
The reward shall be increased?
Yes, increased.
The reward shall be increased.
Gown, gown, gown.
So the reward will be increased. Interesting to say the least. By how much my lips are sealed, be patient, it will be revealed. The pace of storytelling quickens as the pantomime plot thickens.
Hey, door's there.
Yeah, what?
For a job for you.
Oh, yeah, what the soup?
What does Santa's elves learn at school?
I don't know, what do Santa's elves learn at school?
The alphabet.
I've got one as well. Who is Santa's favourite singer?
Oh, who is Santa's favourite singer?
Elvis Presley.
What have we told you, Lottie?
You are not funny. Get up.
Go away.
And you?
These fools are now part of this fable. They must now cut this table.
I've got an idea.
Have you?
Shall we cut it?
We shall. I have a pair of garter shears, you know, just by coincidence.
Jack, I think we've got a slight problem.
Well, what?
The path.
we're coming to.
You stupid boy! Oh, no, for goodness sake!
They're really here! I'm gone! What is that?
What?
It could be a man-eating plant! Or a woman-eating plant!
Quick! Let's get out of here!
No! You should be...
Thank you.
went on a farm later, she's been really lonely on it. So I had the great idea of singing Old MacDonald Has a Farm. You know everyone.
Yes.
Yeah, but I need some helpers to do the animals for me. Well, I heard we have some volunteers in the crowd. So, who's this? Mr. Myers? Who's that? Mr. Myers? Is he up there? There he is, yes. Wearing a bra, and I just got Mr. Manchester. He's wearing a bra. And this man is called Mr. Curtis. That's right, Mr. Curtis. Is that right? Where is it? Mr. Spencer! He is right, Spencer! Alright, so what's gonna happen? We're gonna sing Old MacDonald's a Farm. I'm gonna give you each an animal, yeah, and you have to do it, okay? So you, I want you to be the camel! Yeah! There you are. Really?
out too.
Well, nothing, Mum. It must have grown overnight.
Oh, for goodness sake. Not the hair again. Patrick.
Stop getting
out. Come on.
Another trespasser. This is a diabolical liberty.
Oh, you're not playing today. You're a proper little propagator, you are. This thing is a ginormous. Have you been using 60-lizer?
60-lizer? What's 60-lizer?
Well, if you didn't know, it's double strength 30-lizer. Now, everybody, look at this great big what's it? Why, Greg, grim it himself.
It is an outrage!
This is an outrage, Squire Grey.
Yeah. This is my property, and I don't want any trespassers of any kind, including that.
Yeah. And we are the
Now that would be an outrage. What next?
Then why did you grow it, Squire Grey?
I did not grow it, and I don't want it!
Ooh, do you want to be true?
I find out who is responsible for this monstrosity. I tell you, heads will roll. Aye, heads will roll, I tell you. Get out of my way!
Boo, I'm sure that wasn't growing when we came past 10 minutes ago.
I know, but you couldn't see it otherwise.
Yeah, it's weird. It's just suddenly appeared. Whatever it is.
I reckon there's some kind of beans.
Never mind that. I found this earlier. It's from the palace. It says the reward for the rescue of Princess Mirabel is hereby increased. In addition to the 10,000 golden guineas!
10,000 golden guineas?
There's to be an extensive grant of rich woodland.
Oh.
Farmland! Oh. And a huge mansion! And the hand of the marriage. No, hand of the princess in marriage. If she so desires.
The hand of the princess in marriage?
Yeah.
If she so desires.
What are you doing with my laundry boy? Look at it! Oh!
Oh, Mum, there was a handkerchief, and it had the initials P on it, and a crown!
You had? So you mean you lost my handkerchief?
Oh, yeah!
Oh, for goodness sake!
Well, it had the initials P on it!
Well, I haven't done any washing for David Cameron before.
No, not PM, but Princess Mirabel's initials!
I haven't done any washing for the palace either!
I saw it earlier as well, I did.
Right. I made a wish that I could find a way of reaching Princess Mirabel. That bean must have had magical properties.
That's right, Ma. What is your Squire Chris? Whoa!
You block our names.
Well,
what?
Well, that is a likely story, then. Well, there is the evidence. The bean must have landed on the rich soil of Terrania and started to grow and grow right up into the sky to Cloudland. It's an answer to my wish, a way of fame and fortune.
So you're saying you're going to try and find the beanstalk to try and rescue Princess Myrrh?
Well, not to try, but to succeed.
Then what succeeds?
And I don't believe what does succeed.
A budget without teeth!
That's my boy. I'm so afraid of him. He doesn't know the meaning of fear.
Well, we can look it up in the dictionary.
Do you know what a dictionary is, Billy?
No. Jack, you're not really going to climb the beanstalk, are you?
Well, I am, and I'm hoping you'll come with me, Billy.
Oh, there. No, thanks. I've no head for heights.
True that. He gets giddy walking on a thick pile of carpet.
It'll be a thrilling adventure, Billy. You rescue a princess, a fortune for us up there. 10,000 golden guineas is a lot of money.
It's also a lot of giants!
We'll go halves! 5,000 for me, 5,000 for you! So what did he say?
Well, advance your consideration, Jack. What are we waiting for?
Well, this is where we start. A daring climb, and we're going right to the top!
Yeah!
You can need me coming, no matter where you are, no matter how far. Don't worry, baby, just call my name. I'll be there in a hurry. Don't have to worry, cause baby, there ain't no
then, shall
Ah, yes. Maybe we could go find out then. Gum, gum, gum. Thank you very much. Hear me out, Mama. Oh, this is an awfully long road.
After three now. One, two, three. Heave, ho, heave, ho, heave.
Whoa! I'm there at the top!
Dottie, do you realise that we have just come all the way to the top of Beanstalk?
Well, I don't know why you're complaining. It's me who had to carry all of the equipment. Thank goodness I put my German bra on this morning. It's called a Stoppen von Floppen.
Please stop messing around.
If you remember, we are here to save Mirabelle.
Yes.
Mirabelle, oh yes, of course.
I suggest that we try and find her a new...
Right, let's go. After you, Holiday.
Come, come, come.
After you. I don't think so, young lady.
I don't like Brussels sprouts.
Oh, no.
I bet that one comes trumps up every game, Danny.
Oh, come on!
That was a bit of a JK.
Precisely.
I say it was awfully smelly and very creepy up here. And then something very sinister. I hope you don't get caught.
Oh, my. Oh, no. Right, Danny, here's that. £5, does that owe you?
Gee, thanks.
Well, it's in case if I do get mugged, at least I'll enjoy it.
But there's a lot of costers and coolers around here.
Oh, I don't want to get grabbed by Uncle Dick.
I don't want to be grabbed by the coolers.
Oh, I bet there's lots of ratty things up here.
Yeah, because we saw something really ratty before, didn't we? Dirty, snotty, my parents.
Oh, don't worry, girls. I'm sure we're going to be fine. Because our friends out there are going to see, are going to tell us if they see anything. Aren't they?
Yes! Yes.
So, yes. So let's go have a wee look again to tell us really lightly if you see anything. There's, let's get going.
It's so funny! if only we meet that giant!
Mirabelle, my darling!
What are you doing?
I'm here, I'm so glad you're safe!
Listen, we all need to get out of here!
Well, we can't really, not just yet!
What do you mean, not just yet?
Try
and while he's waiting for us, we can stay here and keep quiet. And then when the coast is clear, we can creep out, find our way to the top of the beanstalk, and climb back down it to Terrania.
I don't want to meet that giant. I'm not partial to giants.
Let us go.
you.
Dreaming, and I'm not a mad crazy old woman. So, You said you wanted to see Princess Mirabelle again, didn't you?
And that and you as well.
Right, okay. So, I'll make a second wish, and I'll wish that Princess Mirabelle, Ider, Hugh, the rest of them, would all get back to Terraria. So. I'm trying to do something here. Well, I'm trying to contact the fairy and I'm getting all of my babes going. So if you don't mind, button it and let me carry on.
Yeah.
I wish that Princess Mirabelle and all the others were back in Terraria now. Now! Well, at least I tried.
It's alright, Mum. It's not your fault. But when I was climbing the beanstalk, I had high hopes of rescuing the princess, so all our problems would be solved.
Oh, don't worry. That'll be alright.
Well, it won't. I guess I was too ambitious, too optimistic, to think I would rescue the princess and become rich. All that might happen in a fairy tale, but never in real life.
This is private property! You are trespassing! Look! Look! You see that sign? Keep out! You deliberately ignored it!
Let an up here, Squire Grey. You better belt up. We've all had it up to here with your yelling, staring, and bullying people. All you are is a miserable, miserly, mischief-making menace. So why don't you do us all a wee little favour? Get back to your private property and take that gun with you as well.
What?
Yes.
That does it. Miserable am I?
Yes.
Miserly am I?
Yes. Yes! And don't forget the menace, you old goat!
Old goat? You have insulted me for the last time! I'll have you out to that cottage by midday tomorrow!
Princess! I thought you were still in Clownland!
Oh, that's funny, lads. Not as slow as I thought, eh?
Who thought you were still in Clownland, Princess?
When we were looking for the beanstalk, Jack, you and Billy suddenly disappeared. So we wandered about home to find you. And then there was a flash, and we found ourselves in that park.
And that horrible man started chasing us, yelling and banging his gun.
Might have been the giant. Not as big, but just as nasty.
I tried to explain to him, but he just wouldn't listen. He's a very disagreeable man.
Well, the problem is with Squire Grey, Princess, is that although he's rich, very rich, he's unhappy. And here in Much Muddling, we've all become used to his bad temper and blustering. We just wish he'd change.
I wish he would change. We all wish he would change.
Hey, what'd you say?
I wish that Squire Grey would change.
Oh, never mind Squire Grey, Princess. On behalf of us all here in Terraria, welcome back to Terraria.
Yeah, happy birthday!
Thank you. I'm happy to be home again with Ida and Hugh, away from Cloudland and that wicked giant, which was made possible by a brave and gallant rescuer, which for I know my mother, the Queen, offered reward for.
Hey, Jack. Will it be the, you know, full reward?
Billy, yeah. I can answer that. Jack, tell me all about the full reward, and I hope you will claim it.
Everybody ready to listen now? Make way for the Queen and Queen Mother of Terraria!
Now, in celebration of the giant's demise, I would like to thank you all the people of the village.
Don't you mean the village people?
It's the same thing, isn't it?
The YMCA! Do you get it? It's the village people!
That's right! Come on, everyone! The village people! The YMCA!
Thank you.
you all enjoying yourselves?
Who do we have here? My darling neighbour, Widow White.
Oh, Squire Grey. It's come over all peculiarly, yes.
Squire Grey, much too formal. Who's the last?
Well, you, on this next bomb. He has changed, and the wish, it must have worked.
You did wish you were changed, didn't you?
Wish, Dottie.
It must have come true.
Oh, we won't be needlessly trespassing, Simon. Open my estate to the whole village. A grand opening ceremony. For a fun fair. Free food. Free food. All expenses paid. What do you say?
Yay! Yes!
Three cheers to Squire Grey. Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip. Hooray!
And so my granting wishes three, I have helped considerably. My magic powers I applied. Now everyone is satisfied. And now all the wrongs have been righted, everyone is now delighted. With troubles gone, the future's rosy, with the prospect looking cosy, good fortune has come to fruition, to end in good pantomime tradition, with merriment and laughter, when all live happily ever after.
So